Hello everyone, welcome to TechQA channel. So in this video we are going to see about a web security testing tool or mobile security testing tool called Bubsuit. So today we are going to cover about proxy. So why we have to use Bubsuit and where and all it will be useful. When you are getting mobile application or web application, when you are creating, like when you are doing some action, you don't know what's happening at backend, in the sense what the request is sending to the server and what response you are getting. And if it is HTTPS secured way, how you can see the response. So based on that, when you are testing the mobile application, you can predict, okay, these are the information coming from the server. If any issue got it from the mobile application, you may check it, is this from mobile app side or API side. So this kind of, somewhat this is security related. So today we'll cover proxy things. So first of all, what you have to do, go to portswigger.net.bub/bub. You just Google it, Bubsuit download. There is enterprises, professional and community version. So let's use free version as of now, that is enough actually. So we are going to do with only proxy. Just download it. So in my case, I have downloaded already. If you are using Windows, download jar file. For Mac, you have separate package, so you can download. Once everything installation done, you can start Bubsuit. Bubsuit community edition. So remember, you have to install community edition, so that is free. So it will, your temporary directory, the following folder previously generated by, would you like to delete? Okay, just delete it, old one. So it will ask next temporary project I'm going to create and start Bub. So once you started Bub, you will get this kind of UI. Here, target, proxy, spider, scanner, intruder, repeater, sequencer. There are a lot of component which we will use it for a security purpose, security testing purpose. So now we are going to concentrate about proxy. So in the proxy, what actually proxy will do, whatever the communication you will do with the server, it will just record everything. So what actually you have to do, for example, if you are going to test some mobile application, whatever the request it's sending from the mobile application, it will just record all the requests as well as response. So that's called proxy. Here, how we can set up. For example, now I'm going to show you for set it up for the mobile devices. So first thing, go to options, add. So click on the specific address. It will show you your IP address, your own IP address. It's second option. Otherwise, what you can do, you can, it will show by default, no worries. And if you want to find your IP address or you want to verify, just ifconfig. Yeah, here I have got it. So it's same only, it's fine. So the port number I want to set, 9999. Okay, now Bubsuit thing is done. Now you have to open the mobile device. Mobile device setting, you have to set a proxy. I will show you how to do with mobile device. Let me open Swagger for you guys. Sorry, Wizor. So it will mirror my device actually. Just give me a second. Once it's installation some Wizor APK, it will show the device here. So if you have mobile application, what you have to do, first of all, you should go to settings first. Yeah, it's done. Go to settings, connections or Wi-Fi connections, Wi-Fi. So just try to find the Wi-Fi, then click on the Wi-Fi connection. So connected Wi-Fi, you should tap for some time or some other way, you should go to the manage network setting or advanced setting. When you click advanced setting, there will be, you can find a proxy. Now it's none. What I have to do, make it manual. The proxy host may be here, this place. You have to type 172.16.2.63, which is my IP address. I have found my system IP address, because the Bubsuit is running in my system, right? So this local machine, so that IP address you have to mention in the mobile device. So whatever request it's going to the server, it will go through my system. So Bubsuit will capture everything. That's why we have to do this binding. So port number we have mentioned 9999. Okay. Once it's done, now what you can do? Go back to proxy, target. Just I will show the device also what I'm trying to do. Just open the Flipkart. Yeah. Now if you see proxy is some colored, go to intercept. So just switch off the intercept actually. What will happen? Otherwise it won't show all the targets. So I can see Flipkart APIs. So by clicking all the request, post method, get method, request and response. For the response, I have got something like status code is 200, page metadata, everything. Okay. When you do more action, it will, whatever it's downloading from the server, everything you can see it here. Okay. There are some applications they won't allow, like they won't allow you to track. That's because of security purpose. They will make it like that. Even with proxy, it won't happen. So now you can track everything HTTP. HTTP only you can. HTTP, yes, it won't show anything. Right. So here what we can do, if you want to do HTTPS configuration, HTTP will come by default. Even all the proxy, by default HTTP will work. But if it is HTTPS, what to do? So go to browser. Any browser in your mobile device, just go to like the URL will be http://burp. Once you're done, click go. In top you can see CA certificate. Okay, you have to click that. So there will be one certificate will be downloaded. So after downloaded, what you have to do, go back to your file manager and like internal storage. In downloads, you can see that file. It will be downloaded as DER something. Yeah, I think DER. I have already downloaded. So there are a lot of file. Leave it. So this DER, what when we have downloaded now, 1438. Just hold for some time. Just rename it. Rename it. Rename the extension DER to CER. So file we already have it, right? So once you rename. Maybe what I can do, I can delete this. CER. Change. Yeah. So after rename, just click. It will ask your password. That's it. Then you have to enter your some certificate name. Anything. Burp certificate. Because after using it, you should delete this certificate. Why? Because it will, like, they may track, someone else can track if they create a proxy. So for your safety purpose, once testing is done, don't like hesitate to delete it. Don't forget to delete. Okay. Now what I can do, I will just close this. Okay. After close, I will just open again the Flipkart. It's already open, right? So let's see what and all HTTP, HTTPS, everything it should show now. Okay. There are some application if they have done with certificate pinning, it won't work. Maybe what I can do, go back to browser also. From browser also, you can go back to something like justdial.com. Okay. I understand the risk. Visit the site. Okay. So HTTPS is enabled now. So even you can see HTTPS with enabled mode. Okay, Flipkart maybe it didn't allow, but after adding the certificate, you can see the HTTPS also, HTTPS response also you can see. So that's what the use of proxy tool. So if you want to do HTTP, you no need to do anything. Now see HTTPS and hit done. So you can see all the things. Okay, this is normal HTTP wala. Okay guys, so this is how we can lean plum something, that's websites HTTPS connection also, it's shows here. Okay, this is how we can do proxy and we can track all the request and response whatever going from your device to the server. So what is the use of it? As I told you already, like you will get to know more about the app. So when you are logging in or sign up, what are the data it's sending to the server and what you are getting as a response. There will be sometime from the device level, it will send it to the server, so like device ID and the location, timing. So everything you will get to know if you read about the response. If you got any error also, something like you can directly go and see the JSON. Okay, what is the expected JSON? Okay, if it is login is not working, you can check what error is coming from the response. Response came properly and still if the mobile device is not working, then there is a problem. Something like page wise number, everything, page URL and so all the collection, these are all maybe unformatted file. Okay, so based on the response, we can try to find the issue and root cause. Okay, and more about Burpsuit is like we can check about spider and scanner, intruder, repeater. There are lot of things. As of now, we have covered only the proxy things. Just try to use proxy. So maybe in future we can try repeater. I can see like which situation you can use repeater or sequences. So free version you can do. You will get very less features to use it free. Okay. Okay, guys. Thanks for your time and please subscribe if you like it and please share the link of channel to your friends. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.